Nigeria's Aviation Minister Adi Sirika says Nigeria's new national carrier will kickstart operations within the first quarter of 2022. Sirika says a memorandum is being forwarded to the Federal Executive Council to approve the business plan for the carrier. Plans for the purchase of aircraft were reported to have been delayed because of the global pandemic, but the minister says arrangements are in top gear to establish the national carrier.
We're coming back to council, hopefully within the next 2 weeks, to present the memo on the national carrier. We went to council to approve the outline business case for the carrier. And then the council raised some questions and asked us to go and fare the memo again and bring it back. So once it comes back and the outline business case is approved by council, then of course we will now go to the full business case, which is now going to the market, and then, you know, establishing the national carrier. Deliveries of the aircraft will be faster, perhaps even the rates might be cheaper, and so on and so forth. So we will go to council on that, and then we will further brief you. But it's on top gear, and we need it more than yesterday. The COVID-19 has exposed the nation, that lack of having a very strong, viable airline, you know, it's bad for the economy of Nigeria and for any country for that matter.
All right, for more on this development, we're now joined by Chris Aligbe, who is an aviation consultant and also CEO of Belgium Consult. Thank you so much for joining us. Well, some Nigerians are celebrating this, while others are saying, does Nigeria really need a national carrier? There are other priorities that, you know, all that funding, about $300 million should be going into. But the question is, what needs to be done to ensure that Nigeria avoids the pitfalls that led, you know, Nigeria Airways into becoming Nigeria Air Waste?
Thank you. You see, the story of Nigeria Airways is completely different from what we are having today. And that's why one has a great hope that what we are looking at, what we are told is coming, it's going to be completely different. Nigeria Airways was managed by government. The airline that is being put across to us is going to be managed by the private sector. It's not going to be government owned. What we heard is that government will own about 5% of 5% equity in that carrier. That is not enough for government to start managing it. And I'm sure that a technical partner, the investor that will come, will take the critical management position in order to bring the airline to run it at a global standard. So that's the first thing. One is going to be, one was owned by the government, and everything that led to its collapse came from government up to the final liquidation. It is government that liquidated it. The airline did not liquidate. The airline did not die. Okay, but what is coming is a different setup completely. Given what the minister has said over time and given what we have read so far, except the indices change. But as of today, what we have is enough to at least prima facie to guarantee an airline that can run the way other airlines run.
Mr. Aligbe, the question that a lot of Nigerians are asking is, how do we run a national carrier when we don't seem to have a policy and clear agenda in terms of our aviation sector, where we know, like Ethiopia, like Kenya and other parts of Africa where they have this, they have the ecosystem working effectively, but we don't seem to have it?
No, well, you can take Ethiopia as a good example. All others may not be good examples because they've had their own problems. Kenya Airways have been in very serious trouble and is managing to try to pull itself out. So if you take Ethiopian Airlines has been government. It was run differently. The government never interfered in the Ethiopian airline. In fact, one of the top MDs of Ethiopian Airlines said to us, there are two governments in Ethiopia, one in Ethiopian Airlines, one in the government house. But here in Nigeria, when we had our own, there was only one government, both in government and both in Nigeria Airways. But now, having said that, we have aviation policy. It's only that people haven't taken time to look at the policy, the aviation policy. The roadmap that we have today stems from the aviation policy. The aviation policy is quite incisive, looking ahead. So what people do not know about it, so maybe you are talking about not being properly put in public domain, but we have aviation policy.
What templates would you recommend? I mean, Ghana is partnering with Ethiopia Airways, and of course, some are saying, should Nigeria start small, or should we start big like, you know, Ghana, or start small like Uganda? What template would you recommend for Nigeria?
If things were what they should be, African countries should be partnering with Nigeria. Nigeria is the largest, virtually largest market, the most stable and reliable market in Africa, even if you know Africa south of Sahara, because we have indigenous traffic. That's why all airlines are coming in here. Even when all the airlines starting, whether they're starting, whatever level they're starting, Ghana is starting today on a small, on a little, a low basis, starting with Ethiopian Airlines. What is their market? Nigeria is their market. Sooner than later, you see all their flight schedule will be focused on Nigeria. So we have the market. We should match our market. And if we should match our, if we are matching our market, we should have larger than any of these countries we have mentioned. These are smaller countries. Yes, they can be doing it right the way, given their own size. But we have the market, we should match our market with whatever we are floating.
Before you go then, how do we begin to see the evolution of this roadmap that you've mentioned? I remember during the era of Stella Odua, Senator Stella Odua, she talked extensively about this roadmap. And before her, there's been a conversation about roadmap. When do we see it evolve or emerge?
Thank you. Yes, it is true. Stella Odua has an excellent roadmap. But I think that he didn't have all the beacons. She didn't have all the beacons to take her through the map. So she had an excellent roadmap, but she didn't find her way. Today we have a roadmap that is clearly stated. I mean, it's clearly stated what the roadmap contains and how to go along it. In the roadmap, we have national carrier, we have maintenance and repair organization, MRO. In the roadmap, we have concession of the airport. Even with all the challenges there, we still believe concession is the best thing to do, provided it is done very well, transparently, with labor in mind, sorting out labor issues. We have aircraft leasing company, which is one of the teething challenges of airlines in Africa and particularly in Nigeria. So we have roadmaps, we have points to get to, and I think that we have beacons on these roadmaps, unlike before. Excellent, I think, to tell you the truth, Stella Odua has one of the best roadmaps ever developed before she came, but there were no beacons. Today we have roadmap, an impressive roadmap, and it has beacons. So it is for us to follow the beacons.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chris Aligbe, for your contribution, aviation expert and consultant. Thank you very much.